Thompson, and this is Rough Draft, a show about writing, where we're going to share everything that we know about writing and everything that we've done on writing. Today I have Christopher Shawn with me from Everybody Has a Story podcast, and he is also one of my alpha readers. And for everyone who doesn't know what an alpha reader or an alpha reader group is, it's like a test audience that gets to read my book, and I interact with them, and they comment back and forth before it ever goes to see a publisher or agent or anything like that. So it's just a test, kind of like a test group that we do. So you have read chapter one.
Yes, I have.
Yes, and why don't you tell us what you thought of chapter one?
First of all, I was intrigued. I love pirate books, so you had me at that, and it's an awesome book. The first chapter really grabs you, which, you know, when you're reading a book, you look for that. You look within the first couple chapters, you decide if you're going to keep reading. Well, I'm like stoked to read the next chapter. I mean, you know, the fact that it's a strong it's a female pirate, first of all, and that she's strong and that she brings that pirate presence, but also has like class to it too. So she doesn't lose that she's a female. It's not like a female turned rogue pirate and lost all humanity or anything like that. It's like, you know, she's a pirate, but she's a lady at the same time, you know? So I love that. I love it. And it's amazing. So I can't wait to read on.
Well, thanks. I love hearing back comments from the people who have read my book, because like I said, like, I've been writing this book for 4 years, and so I've had it to myself for 4 years, so to get to see it through other people's eyes is, it just makes me feel good.
I'm glad you trust me with your baby. Most people wouldn't. No. He's like, oh no, no more chapters for you.
Oh goodness. Okay, so you have a couple of questions though for me, right?
I do.
Okay.
So, well, my first question is I really want to know, like, what influenced you to write The Dark Age?
Okay, so all of my ideas or my stories come from dreams. I don't know if that's weird, but all of my stories come from dreams. I've heard that that is, like, the most creative process, dreaming is.
Right.
And so it was a dream that I had that was constant. Like, every night when I went to sleep, like, it continued on. And after a while, I was like, this is, like, an awesome story. Like, if I was reading this, I'm interested, and it's my dream. And so that's what gave me the idea of writing it. And how I continued on, I don't know.
Well, yeah, first of all, I want to comment on you do dream. I've had dreams, and you're lucky to keep having a dream, because there's been times where I dreamed and I just want to, like, hit myself back over the head, like just so I can start right back where it came from. I want to keep dreaming. Like, can I please just let me go back to sleep and finish this dream? So I could almost imagine if you have that dream every night and you're like, yeah, I gotta write this down.
Yeah, it was pretty fun.
All right, so then why a female pirate, and how hard is it to capture her role? And because pirates is such a male-dominant role.
Okay, so that has to do with the characters themselves. A lot of the characters, not all of them, but a lot of the characters actually depict real people in my life. I know, but let's remember that it doesn't always represent who they
are. In the present, right?
Yes. It's funny because I had one of the people read their part, and she was like, okay, so not all of this is real, right?
How true is it?
And she's like, and if it is, just don't tell me. So it wasn't very hard to write her character, because I basically depicted a part of her life when she was in a darker area.
Okay.
And so it wasn't hard at all. It seemed very natural to me to put these specific people in character roles.
Has said person read the entire book?
Well, which one?
Your lead.
You're talking to her.
Oh. Read the book. You guys have got
it. The first character is based off of my personality. Not me, but my personality. So, and back in time a little.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Nice.
That's kind of a little giveaway.
I can't wait to get to the next chapter of this book. So, is this your first story?
No, it's not my first story, but it's the first one that I've actually finished. I have other stories, and like we were talking before, I like them, and their storyline or their ideas, but this one kind of landed in a different part of my life. All those stories I probably wrote over 10 years ago. And I, like I said, I took 4 years to write this story, but it was kind of therapy for me.
Okay.
Because, you know, we have to go back to the recession and people losing their homes and cars, and we fit in among that group, and it really helped me to be able to have this story and to be able to express it.
That clears up kind of a lot for me, because like the recession is like a pirate type era in America. Like, things going on.
You're trying to
hang on. Yeah. There's looting going on. He took my house. I mean, it's wow. And then knowing you and knowing that was a shocker for me. That was a little spoiler alert, but I'm glad now I can enjoy the story even more, and I'll have more questions.
No, maybe now you'll be more afraid.
Oh yeah. Well, I'm afraid. Well, so like you said in the beginning, like I know that because I'm one of your alpha readers, that we are in the alpha reader stage, but when is the book coming out?
We don't have an actual date for the book coming out yet. Right now, you can follow us on Facebook. There's a complete synopsis on there and all the things that we are doing leading us up to that moment. But right now it doesn't have a release date. We are going to be doing a sharing contest, though. So if you get on there and share and leave your email, you can win a poster. And everybody who shares is going to get the first chapter of the book. So
nice.
They'll get the teaser chapter.
Nice.
Definitely.
Which is a good teaser chapter. That is awesome. So... Well, that's all the questions I have. I can't wait to get to chapter 2.
Well, you have the whole book.
Don't tell them. I don't want people coming to my house. Hi, you got the first.
So.
The whole book. I'm going to get robbed for your book.
All right. Well, so, Chris, tell us where we can find you.
Okay, well, you can find me on Facebook, Everybody Has a Story. Well, Facebook / Everybody Has a Story. I'm also on YouTube. So on YouTube is youtube.com/ EHAS Show. So EHAS Show. Currently, we're putting up some new videos and we're doing different things. The podcast will start soon. We're not in our alpha reader stage, but we're ready to come out. But yeah, you'll see us. Come on YouTube, Facebook, and yeah, that's where you can find me. Thanks.
And also, you can email any questions or comments that you have to us at darkeveseries@gmail.com. Also, please join and support us by liking our page on Facebook, which is facebook.com/thedarkeve. That's where you can share the site and get in on the contest. And also subscribe to our YouTube channel to follow along with us on this great journey. Well, thanks, Chris, for
also,
coming.
Also, real quick before we end,
what?
The poster is amazing for this book. You have got to get this poster. It's awesome.
Yeah. They have the images online. but the posters, those aren't going to, the images that are online right now, those aren't going to be the actual final images. Those
okay.
ones were kind of like a test photo shoot.
Wow.
We're still waiting for a couple of things to come in, and then we're going to be doing the final photo shoot, and so we'll be excited for those images to actually, you know, get together and come out.
Awesome. Can't wait.
Thank you so much for joining us today. Like I said, please like us and subscribe to our channel.